Hello everyone and welcome to another With Electronic ISOS webinar. My name is Markus Eberle and I will moderate this webinar today. We are very pleased that you took the time to participate in our webinar. The topic of today's webinar is supplemental lighting in greenhouses with horticulture LEDs. Our speaker today is Johann Waldherr, who is working as Business Development Manager in the field of electronic power and lighting solutions at With Electronic ISOS. He will hold today's webinar and also answer your questions. Before we start the webinar, I would like to point out one thing. You will be muted during the webinar today. This means that you cannot ask us questions via microphone during the webinar. Nevertheless, you have the opportunity to ask us questions during the webinar at any time via the chat function. You will find the chat function in the webinar control panel. Today's webinar will be about 30 minutes long. The chat questions will then be answered in a question answer session following the webinar. There are also 10 to 15 minutes in addition scheduled for this. If we are unable to answer all your questions within this time, we will answer them via email after the webinar. And if you still have any other questions left after the webinar, just email us at isos-webinar@we-online.com. At the end of the webinar, you will be asked to participate in the feedback survey. Of course, we would be pleased if you take the time to fill out the survey and help us to improve our webinars. And you will also receive the link to the presentation as well as to the recording of today's webinar only in the next few days. And now I will hand over to our speaker, Johann, and I wish you an exciting webinar.
So thanks, Markus, for the introduction. And also welcome from my side to this webinar, Supplemental Lighting in Greenhouses with Horticulture LEDs. Should see my screen. Yeah, my name is Johann Waldherr. I'm Business Development Manager for Horticulture LEDs here at Wirth Electronic. And today I prepared following agenda for us. First, I will give an overview about why we use supplemental lighting in greenhouses. Then I will focus on the characteristics of horticulture lighting. After that, I show you our portfolio. So which LEDs are in our portfolio. I will give an overview about the benefits and about the benefits of LEDs in horticulture lighting. And in the end, I will focus on our tools and our service, especially on how to use the horticulator, what is the horticulator, and yeah, how you can work with it. So why do we use supplemental lighting in greenhouses? So it's not new. The gardener use supplemental lighting since a long time in greenhouses. The current used light source is mostly an HPS luminaire. So it's not a new technology. It is important to note light is essential for the plant development. So without light, it's not possible to cultivate plants. But very often the available sunlight is not enough. So for example, we have cloudy days or rainy days, or in the winter, the days are too short. So this leads to not enough photons, not enough light energy the plant can use for their development. So, and that's the reason why we also use artificial light in a greenhouse. With the artificial light, we can control the photosynthesis, the morphology, the photodivision of a plant. So the photosynthesis is the most important mechanism in a plant. Photosynthesis controls nearly each plant developmental stage. In addition to the control of these three mechanisms, We also can optimize different quality parameters of a plant with artificial light. Different quality parameters are, for example, more biomass, better flowering, target flowering, faster flowering, or increase the secondary plant metabolites in the plant. Secondary plant metabolites are, for example, vitamins for us. Also, improving the flavor or better rooting are also quality parameters. So when we know the target of the gardener, we can optimize the light spectrum. And this leads to an optimized plant growth. But later, more infos about that. The applications in supplemental lighting in greenhouses are separated in two big application areas. The first one is the top lighting. So this is the lighting from the top of the plant. The distance here is very big compared to vertical farming, for example. So the distance between luminaire and plant mostly is more than 1 or 2 meters. So therefore, we use normally high power LEDs here. Then the other application in supplemental lighting in greenhouses is the intercanopy lighting. This is the lighting between the plants. You can see here in the right picture. This is similar to the lighting in vertical farms. So you put the lights, the LEDs, very close to the plant in between the plant rows. This is possible also with the LEDs technology because the heat generation is very low here. So we can place the luminaire with the LEDs very close to the plant. So on the next slides, I will give you an overview about different characteristics in horticulture lighting. So for those who already attend the webinar last week, where I focused on vertical farming, this is, I think, a good repetition for all others. I will focus now on biological basics, on optical basics, and electrical basics in horticulture lighting. So the most important aspects and parameters. I will start with the biological basics. Again, what does a plant need? Light is essential for the plant growth. Here on the left side in this picture, you see different photoreceptors of the plants and where these photoreceptors absorb the light. You can see also the most important ones. So these are not the only photoreceptors, there exists many more, but these are the most important ones. You see, the plant absorbs a lot of light in the blue region here and a lot of light in the red region. The most important wavelengths are here the 450 nanometer, the 660 nanometer, and the 730 nanometer. These three wavelengths we defined as horticulture wavelengths. And then you also see borders between 400 to 700 nanometer. This is the so-called PAR region. This is the region the plants are able to use for photosynthesis. So these wavelengths here between 400 to 700, the plant uses for photosynthesis. And outside of this border, so after 700 and below 400, this is also an important region. The region from 280 to 800 nanometer is this the so-called plant biological active radiation and the PBRAR region, in which the plant can recognize the light. For example, the UVA wavelengths are important to increase secondary plant metabolites. The 730 nanometer wavelength is important in combination with the 660 for the flowering process. So you see, with different wavelengths, you can influence different plant quality parameters. And I also want to mention again, so these are not the only photoreceptors. We also have photoreceptors here in the green or yellow region. And they are also important for other quality parameters of the plant. But here in this picture, we show the most important ones. Then I continue with the optical basics. Here you see in these pictures in the background again the photoreceptors of the plants, which I showed in the slide before. In addition to that, you see the light emitted, the LEDs of us, which we developed for horticulture lighting with the wavelengths emitted in the at the 450 nanometer, at the 460 nanometer, at 730 nanometer. So we developed LEDs with exactly these wavelengths which the plant can absorb. And of course, we also have other wavelengths like in the green, in here in the UV region, yellow, so that we can define the correct spectrum for different quality parameters of the plant. And this is suitable for all horticulture lighting applications. So we deliver the photons, the wavelengths the plant can absorb. This is important to understand and to know. So we also, or with the LED technology, we are able to adjust the spectrum. So the LEDs are monochromatic. You have the possibility to use monochromatic LEDs. So with this, you can adjust the spectrum. You can define light recipes to obtain the optimal plant growth and development and quality of the plant. You are also able to dime the LEDs separately. So you can dime, for example, all the blue LEDs and all hyper-red LEDs separately. This leads to a dynamic lighting, for example. So you can adapt the luminaire to the environmental conditions, for example, if you have a feedback regulation with sensors in the greenhouse. So you can increase light intensity when there is not enough sunlight outside. You can decrease light intensity, for example, when there is enough sunlight. But you also can adapt the lighting system on different vegetation stadiums of the plants. For example, seedlings need a different light combination ratio for of blue and red than, for example, fruiting plants. Here on this slide, you can see on the left side an action spectrum for plant growth with the focus plant growth. On the right side with the focus flowering. So here you see we have this far red peak, the 730 nanometer. You find many more informations why you use far red in our application note on our web page. Okay, to continue with the basics, I will focus now after the biological and optical basics on the electrical basics. Here we have three important parameters. The first one is the PPF value, the second is the PPFD, and the third is the PPE. The PPF, the photosynthetic photon flux, is the amount of all photons emitted from light sources in all directions per second. This is shown here on the left side of this picture. So this is the amount of photons which comes out of my LED. The unit is micromole per second. The second parameter is the PPFD, the photosynthetic photon flux density. This is the amount of photons that hit one square meter per second. So it's shown here in the middle. This is the amount of photons the plant really can use for their photosynthesis. The unit is micromole per square meter in a second. And the third one is the PPE, the photon efficacy. This refers to how efficient a lighting system is at converting electrical energy into photons of power. The unit is micromole per joule. Important here is to know in plant lighting, the lumen or lux play not a really important role. You can compare, for example, the PPF value with is comparable with lumen, for example. So in human lighting, you have the lumen value. In plant lighting, you have the PPF value. In human lighting, you have the lux value. In plant lighting, the comparable value is the PPFD. And the third one is the efficacy, the PPE in plant lighting. It's comparable with lumen per watt when you have a look in human lighting. So important plant lighting, we have these three parameters, which are important. Okay, then which LEDs do we have in our portfolio? I already mentioned we have the three special horticulture wavelengths, 450, 660, and 730 nanometer. And of course, we have a lot of other different wavelengths to create customized action spectrum, customized light recipes for different plant quality parameter. So we also have the UVA. We also have full color white LEDs. Sometimes you also need these LEDs. The big benefits, as I said, we can adjust the spectrum. We can adapt the spectrum to the plant. The LEDs have a high efficacy. The LEDs have a high PPF output. And these LEDs have all the same size. You find more information again on our webpage. So there you can find the data sheets. You can find the output values, PPF, and many other informations. On this slide, I show you the high power products. High power products mostly are used in supplemental lighting in greenhouses because you need a lot of output because the distance is mostly very big between plant and luminaire. But we also have mid-power LEDs. Again, we have here our horticulture wavelengths, the 450, 660, 730, a lot of other colors. And also here, our new mid-power white LEDs with the size 3030. These LEDs are very efficient and they are also used very often in greenhouse lighting system. The benefits here is low power solution. Again, we can adjust the spectrum. We can adapt the spectrum to the plant needs. Yeah, there's no need for expensive cooling here. Again, very high efficacy. And you can increase the homogeneity of the illumination on the target area with mid-power LEDs. Okay, so now on the next slide, I will focus more on the benefits of LEDs. One big benefit of the LED technology and horticulture lighting is the lifetime. So when you operate the LEDs at an appropriate temperature, the LEDs have a lifetime of more than 60,000 hours. This is more than 9 years with a daily lighting of 18 hours. Nearly 14 years when you have a daily lighting of 12 hours. more than 20 years if you have a daily lighting of 8 hours. Compared to HPS luminaires, HPS lamps, which have a lifetime of around 10,000 to 24,000 hours, and compared to a metal halide luminaire, which has a lifetime of 6,000 to 20,000 hours, this is a big increase. You find many more information about lifetime on our webpage again in the following app note. Then another big benefit is the efficacy of the LEDs. When you have a look here, or when you compare the LEDs with standard light sources in 2017, the LED technology was a little bit better than the HPS luminaires. So we had 2017 a PPE value of 2.5 micromoles per joule at the LED technology. A double-ended HPS lamp was at 2.1 micromoles per joule. Now, we already reached with our LEDs a PPE of 4.0 micromoles per joule. So you see there's a big increase and our LEDs getting more and more efficient. And in addition to that, we can deliver exactly the wavelengths, so the light energy the plant really use. And this is again a big benefit. And we save a lot of energy, and this leads to a lot of savings for the gardener in energy costs. And here, a short summary of the benefits of horticulture LEDs for the gardener. I separated in biological and electrical benefits. So biological benefits is that the gardener can cultivate year round, is weather independent. He can increase the plant quality parameters, so he can have uniform plant quality, target flowering, better rooting. All this he can achieve with dynamic lighting. And of course, they have a high harvest efficiency. So the gardener can control the plant development with dynamic lighting again and with different action spectrum. On the electrical side, we also have many benefits with horticulture LEDs. So the lifetime is very high. The efficacy is very high. This leads to lower maintenance costs, lower operating costs. You can adjust the spectrum to the plant needs. The LEDs are dimmable, so you can adapt the light intensity to the environmental conditions and also the spectrum to the different plant developmental stages, which again leads to an increase in yield. And both together leads to a fast return of invest for the gardener and in addition to more profit. Yeah, what else do you have to consider? In this webinar, we will focus on the LEDs, but there are many more aspects you have to consider when you develop a horticulture luminaire for greenhouses. Do you need optics? Yes, no. Which optics? With which viewing angel, beam angel? How you should design the cooling of the luminaire? Then there are two standards which are very important. The UL 8800 of the UL standard is the UL standard for horticulture lighting equipment and systems. And the second one is the ASABES 640 standard of the American Society of Agricultural and Biological Engineers. These two are the most important standards which exist at the moment for horticulture lighting. Then you also have to think about how to control the luminaire. How should be the power input, the input voltage? is there feedback regulation between Lumina and sensors? So is also important point to consider. IP safety. So this is a special environment, a greenhouse. So you need IP65 or IP67. And of course, the geometry of the Lumina is also an important point. The goal is to avoid too much shadow with the Lumina. So you also have to think about this design here. And addition to all this, yeah, how does the heating cost change with a Lumina which has horticultural LEDs? You know, the heat management of LEDs is much better comparable to HPS luminaires, and this can lead to higher costs for the gardener with in the heating system. But you also, yeah, you have to calculate this, and there you also can calculate, okay, what are the savings of the gardener, for example, for additional cooling. Because in the winter, okay, perhaps the gardener needs more heat, but in the winter, the gardener doesn't need an extra cooling system because the LEDs have a good heat management. Then there also is going on a lot of research to influence with different wavelengths. The leaf temperature of the plants, for example. This is are all points, important points you have to consider. And when you put this all in your calculation, and then you can find out if the Lumina with horticulture LEDs is suitable for different greenhouses. Depends always on the greenhouse, if it's suitable, if it's rentable or not. But later a little bit more to this topic. Then on the next slides, I will focus on our tools which we provide to you and which you can use to develop your own luminaire, your spectrum for your luminaire. The first one is here, the RedExpert tool, the integrated horticulator in the RedExpert tool. So this is an application support. In this tool, all our LEDs are included. So you can select all the LEDs I showed you before and make your own light recipe with these LEDs. It is a lamp design support tool for shorten the development time. You can test the results and see how they look like. You can compute your optoelectrical parameters. And of course, you can test your ideas and estimate the output of your lamp. The PPF value, the power usage, the red to blue ratio, and much more is directly computed in this tool. You can order free samples, you have a quick access to the data sheet. How to work with the RedExpert? You have to add the LEDs to the lamp, so you have to add the number of LEDs here. You can change the driving current and you can change the temperature. And as results, you get the total photon flux output in PAR and PBR AR, so it's shown here. You get the as a result the light distribution of red, green, blue, the total efficiency, and of course you get the emission spectrum of your light receptor, shown here for example. How can I find the horticulator? You have to register at RedExpert. Then you have to click on the button products. And the third step is go to Optoelectronics and select the menu item horticulture LEDs. And then you can start to develop your own light recipe for different plant quality parameters. Here I will give you a short example how you can do this. First, you need to know, okay, what are the target parameters? In this example, the target output is 1600 micromole per second. The ratio between hyper-red LEDs and the blue LEDs should be 80% red, 20% blue. So then you know, okay, my target output is 1280 micromoles per second in the red region with hyper-red and 320 micromoles in the blue region with deep blue. Now you can open the articulator. In this example, you say, okay, I will drive my LEDs with 500 milliamps. You change the forward current here to 500 milliamps. Then you will see, okay, with 500 milliamps, my output is more than around 4 micromoles per second with one LED. Then you know, okay, I need 364 hyper-red LEDs to reach my target output of 1280 micromoles per second. And the same you will do also for the blue LEDs. And then you get the necessary number of LEDs you have to use in your luminaire. You get all the other results I showed you in the slides before too. For example, the total input power is 680 watt for this luminaire. So how can you use this information then to show also the energy savings to the gardener? So yeah, you have to talk with your customer, with the gardener. You have to get infos about the frame conditions. Here, the first step we already did with in the articulator. So we calculated the necessary amount of LEDs. Then the second step is ask the gardener, what is the energy cost? So how much they have to pay for 1 kilowatt hour. In this example, we used 29 cents per kilowatt hour. Then the third step is ask the gardener, how long is the lighting, that is the lumina working in 1 year? So check the lighting hours per year. In this example, we said, okay, in January, the gardener will use the lumina 10 hours per day, in February 6, and October 2, and November 8, and December 10. Then you can calculate the amount of lighting hours per month, and you have the total hours per year. So now, with this information, you can calculate the energy costs per year of the gardener. Therefore, you use the total lighting hours per year, multiply it with the power input, which we calculated here with the horticulator in the slide before. And the result is that you get the kilowatt hours per year for one luminaire. The second step is you take this result, multiply it with the price for 1 kilowatt hour, and you get the energy costs per year per luminaire. So now you can do this also with the competitor product, in this case with the HBS luminaire, and you can compare your luminaire with the LEDs with the competitor product, the HPS luminaire. Here you have to consider, of course, number of luminaires in the greenhouse, the heating costs, higher yield with LEDs, for example. And then you can show the gardener when is the system with the horticulture LEDs rentable. Okay, so this is one example how you can use the horticulator and how you can also use the horticulator in combination to show the energy savings for the gardener. The next tool is the Horti Development Kit. The Horti Development Kit is a 2-in-1 lighting kit, which provides an easy solution to either mix RGB and white color for different lighting situations and amplify the growth of plants with the horticulture panel. So in this kit is LED panel included with our horticulture LEDs, with white LEDs, with RGB LEDs. We have a power board with 4 channels. We can control each of these 4 channels separately. So we can control them via our app, VE Illuminate. This is, you have access, yeah, you have a free access for this app. So you can dim the different LEDs separately from null, from 0 to 100%. There are also optics included, a power supply, a cooling body, everything what you need for your first luminaire. Here in the picture below, you also see our grow chambers, which we set up in Waldenburg in our headquarter. Therefore, we use also this lightning kit. Then we also have a lot of application notes, all available on our webpage here. And yeah, there you can get deeper, much more information about horticulture lighting. So again, why should you choose Wirth Electronic? Our LEDs have a very high PPF output, high PP value. We deliver the whole necessary spectrum for all horticulture lighting application. And of course, we help you to find the right LEDs. Doesn't matter mid power, high power, full color, monocolor, for each unique application and target plant quality parameter. Therefore, we have also own plant scientists in our team. We have cooperations with universities, and we have, yeah, we get a lot of know-how through own biological tests. So we do research to find the optimum light recipe, the optimum action spectrum for different quality parameter of the plant. Here you also can see 3 examples, 3 experiments. The left one was an example with Basil. You see different light conditions leads to different plant phenotype. The second one was an experiment with spinach. So we managed it to double the amount of secondary plant metabolites with dynamic lighting after 8 days. Secondary plant metabolites, for example, are vitamins for us. And here on the right side, we also have an experiment in a greenhouse with tomatoes. So we induced the flowering process in the winter months, and we managed it to increase the flowering process more than 40% compared to other light sources. So you see, we have a lot of knowledge, and we do own research on different light recipes, action spectrums for different quality parameters. And this knowledge we share, and this is your knowledge we use to select with you the right LED combination for your luminaire. Yeah, as a summary, I hope you got a first impression about supplemental lighting in greenhouses with horticulture LEDs. You can go on our webpage www.we-online.com/letitgrow. There you can find all information which I provided to you today. So from my side, thanks for your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to ask now.
Yeah, so thank you, Johan, for your interesting presentation. As you have mentioned, now we would like to turn our attention to your questions. And so we wait a little until some questions come in. You can just ask us the questions with the chat tool. You will find that in the webinar control panel. So, Johan, I see the first question here. Has Wirth Electronic their own luminaires?
This is a good question. This is a question I also received in my last webinar. So no, we have no own luminaire. We will provide the components for the luminaire. So we are manufacturer of electrical and electromechanical components, also sensors. So we deliver more or less everything you need to develop your own luminaire. What we have is the lighting kit. So this is a kind of own luminaire. This is a development kit which you can use to develop your luminaire. But already in this lighting kit, everything is included, like power supply, optics, cooling body, LED panel, power board with different channels. So this is what we offer. And of course, we will help you to find the right LED combination for your luminaire. So we give you also suggestions and also points you should consider when you develop a luminaire, but the develop you have to do by your own.
Okay, thank you, Johan, for your explanation. Then, as we have a look at the next question, just a hint from my side, you will receive the link to this presentation as well as to the recording of today's webinar only in the next few days. So then, Johan, next question. How do I know the right spectrum?
Also this is a good question and a tricky question. You always have to talk with the gardener in this case and find out what is his goal. So what is the target plant quality parameter? When you know this, you can optimize your spectrum and you can select the right LED combination. If not, you also can use something like I will call it now easy spectrum or an action spectrum. So we know, for example, that in general in mostly plants, UVA light, also a higher content of blue, can influence the secondary plant metabolites, can increase the secondary plant metabolites. Okay, you know this. So then we also can make a general action spectrum, which fits to more plants and more plant varieties. For the one plant, it's perhaps working better than for the other plant, but it will work for all of these. And yeah, this is something how you can create such light spectrum and how you can find out the right spectrum.
Okay, thank you. Then I see the last question for now. Maybe there will be more question. Also just a hint, if you have still any other questions after the webinar, you can also just email us at the email addresses you can see here on the slide. So, Johan, how should a luminaire look like in a greenhouse?
How should a luminaire look like in a greenhouse? Also, thank you for this question. This is not easy to answer. So there are a few aspects you have to consider and you have to keep in your mind. So important is geometry of the luminaire. So it's important to avoid too much shadow, so that enough or optimum amount of sunlight can get in the greenhouse. Mm-hmm. Then, in my opinion, a luminaire also should be dimmable, so that you can have on the one side a dynamic lighting with the adaption to different plant developmental stages, so that you can separately dim, for example, hyper red and deep blue. But of course, it should be also have something like a feedback reaction with sensors. So when, for example, the sunlight is enough outside, that the luminaire automatically decrease the light intensity. So you can also save, again, energy and money. And of course, yeah, the luminaire should be energy efficient. You have to think about, do you need optics or not? Depends on the greenhouse. And a correct cooling is very important to make sure that the lifetime is really about 60,000 hours.
Okay. So thank you for your explanation. Then, as we have no further questions at the moment, we are finished with our webinar. Yeah, so thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you enjoyed our webinar. Also, many thanks to you, Johan, for this great webinar.
Yeah, thanks also from my side to everybody here. And feel free to get in contact also after the webinar with me. And yeah, you're always welcome to ask me questions, and I will try to answer. So thanks and have a nice day.
Yeah, also from my side, I hope you will hear us at our next webinar, and I wish you also a good day. So goodbye.